Hey guys, so today I am doing another speed build in Sulani. Surprise, surprise. This is the third build that I've done in this world so far, and it's probably not going to be my last. But this time we are not doing a residential lot. Today we are doing a community lot. This originally started out as a library, but I actually ended up turning it into a cafe. I don't typically do community lot builds. I think the most I've really done on this channel in terms of community lots has been restaurants. But here we are doing something a little bit different this time. We are doing this community lot, and I was actually inspired to do this by watching, I think it was the English Simmers Island Living Let's Play. I basically started watching everyone's Island Living Let's Plays as soon as the game launched, and everyone started bringing out their Let's Plays. So I'm watching Deligracies, The Sim Supplies, and The English Shimmers, but it was The English Shimmers Let's Play that I got inspired to create a community lot, because she actually uses a community lot in her Let's Play, which I think was a really smart idea, especially if your Sims are living off the grid and don't have access to computers and things like that because you don't have electricity. So I think it's cool to have a community lot that you can go to so that you can actually, you know, use computers, use water, use electricity, that kind of thing. That's kind of the purpose of this build. It did kind of start off as a library because, you know, I put in like a whole library section and there's computers and things like that, but then it evolved and I made it into a cafe because I wanted to use all the functional cafe stuff as well. And there's also a gym, which I do actually end up adding in later. There's like a little upstairs bit I added as well, because I did name this a community lot, and I felt like for it to really be like a community center, it had to have a lot more in it than just a library. So I wanted it to be pretty functional, to do a lot of things so that your Sims could come together and hang out here. So I thought this was a little bit of fun, something a little bit different for me because I never really do builds like these. And I actually think the reason why I don't do builds like this is because I find it really hard to make community lots interesting and different, because it's not something I normally do. And when I play The Sims, actually my Sims never really leave their home lot. They always seem to stay there. They never travel or anything like that. And I think the reason why that is for me is because whenever I first started to play The Sims on the PC, I played Sims 2 and I played on a crappy laptop, and Sims 2 and Sims 4 have a similar mechanism for changing lots. So, you know, every time you move to your lot, you know, there'd be a loading screen. And when I played Sims 2 on this crappy laptop, obviously it took a year and a half to load every time my Sim wanted to go to a different lot. So I think I've just kind of instilled it in my head not to change lots often, otherwise I'm gonna have to sit through a loading screen. Obviously now I have a brand new computer. Well, it's not really brand new now, I've had it for quite a while, but like, it's better than my laptop was, and it runs Sims 4 a lot faster, and my loading screens don't take a year and a half. So I can normally travel between lots with ease, but I just choose not to do it. So hence why I don't really build community lots and things like that, because I don't really use them and I don't really think about them. And like I said, I don't really know how to make them interesting, because I always see people create amazing things on the gallery and they always do like really fun things. And you know, they always make the community lots and things that are kind of dull seem really interesting. And I just struggle to do that. But with this one, I wanted to take a chance. I really wanted to make a cute little community place where Sims could get together. And this is actually a little bit inspired by the Sims 2 University dorm build that I did. I did a little tour of that on my channel if you guys want to check that out. But yeah, I was inspired by that build to do this build because it kind of has a similar structure in that it's very sectioned off, as in it has its different sections for specific things, and also the library room. I was kind of inspired to do that just because I built a library in The Sims 2. Not that it's difficult to build a library, like you guys saw, I literally just stuffed a bunch of bookcases in one room, but still, something I never really do in The Sims, so I thought I would. Oh! Guys, I can't believe I got like halfway through this video and haven't mentioned it yet, but I managed to build this entire community lot only using Island Living, Get Together, and my BS game. So yeah, That was a big accomplishment for me. Obviously, you did see me put in the doors from Spa Day for the bathrooms, but I do actually change that because I was like, no, I really want to try to build using as little packs as possible. Because as I was building, I was kind of realizing I was only really using stuff from Base Game as well as Island Living, so I kind of wanted to keep it, minimal. Because I do know that when I build, I kind of just use whatever and I don't really think about it. This time, I really tried to stick to as little packs as possible, and I did it. So, yeah, you guys can download this if you have Get Together and Island Living. You don't even really need Get Together, if I'm honest. Like, the only reason that you need Get Together is because you can't have a cafe lot if you don't have Get Together. And there's a few other things from Get Together I threw in there as well, such as the Don't Wake the Llama game and stuff like that. But I only threw those in because I was using that pack already to make a cafe, so I thought, why not just throw in a couple of extra things from Get Together just to fill out the space. Like I said, I don't really think about the packs I'm using when I build because I just kind of go for everything because I have almost everything. But when I watch some YouTubers build and they do pack specific builds, and they challenge themselves to only use a certain amount of stuff in their builds, I'm reminded, oh yeah, not everyone has everything, and so maybe you want to download something that I built, but you can't because I use items from every pack. But yeah, I just thought it was kind of cool that I was able to do this only using the two packs that I decided to use. And really, when I think about it, I don't think it would be that difficult to do other builds like this. Obviously, I think personally, it's a lot easier to make a community lot using less packs than it is to build a house, because with community lots, you don't really have to go into as much detail in decorating and things like that. I mean, you totally can if you want to, that's up to you, but I feel like I did have the urge to want to fill every single space in this lot with something, but at the same time, I was like, no, this is like a community space, this is like where a bunch of people get together. It can be like a little bit open, it doesn't need to have like all the stuff that I normally would put in a build, because you guys know I love a good cluttered house build. But yeah, so this is like different because I wasn't like really trying to cover the place in decorative items. I mean, towards the end, I do go in and I do put like decorative things here and there, but I just wanted it to have a little bit more personality than just having your basic ass items that you need. But yeah, overall, I'm really happy with this build. I really like the way it turned out. I think it's really nice. I definitely think this is something that your Sims and Sulani could use if they're living off the grid and they need to get to a place where you can use electricity and you can use water, because there's even showers upstairs. Because there's a gym upstairs, so you can shower there as well. And there is like a little bit of a kitchen area, so you can also, get food. And there's also two barbecue areas, because I just really went OTT with all the places you can have food in this place. Anyway, I think that's everything I want to say. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe for more. And you can download this on The Sims 4 Gallery. All you have to do is search Simming and Such or hashtag Sulani Community Center, Community Hub, something along those lines. I did actually submit this build for one of the Sim Supply's build videos. So the Sim Supply does a series where he like goes through a hashtag and checks out people's builds on The Sims, and he's doing one that is for tropical builds. So my build is also hashtagged tropical builds for Samaj. I don't know if he's actually going to see it because there's a very slim chance that he will, but just letting you guys know, I put myself out there and yeah. We see if I'm in his video. If not, it's totally cool. No hard feelings. It's fine. I just thought I'd like put myself out there because I know that I don't build as great as some other people build, especially in the Sim Supply series he's been doing. I've like been watching the builds and people build really amazing, outlandish things that I can never do. But, still wanted to take a chance because you never really know what's going to happen. But yeah, anyway, I'm actually going to go now because I feel like I've been rambling quite a lot this video. Like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.